Hello friends, welcome to the LitModes YouTube platform. As you better know, we are running a series known as Pramarth series in which we have promised that we will deliver you at least 500 questions for upcoming RBI Gate B Phase 1 examination. In our previous video, we have already discussed 115 questions, like 115 questions, and in this video, in this particular video, we will discuss at least 200 questions in one go. So you just have to see the questions and guess the correct answer, and there you go. So let's get started. Question number one. Name the current chief economic advisor. So you have to name the current chief economic advisor, and options are given there. And let me tell you that Economic Survey of India is a document which is released by the Ministry of Finance. Okay, so you also have to remember the name of ministry, and this document is prepared by the DEA, means Department of Economic Affairs, under the guidance of Chief Economic Advisor. So the Chief Economic Advisor of the India is Krishnamurthy Subramaniam. Arvind Subramaniam was the former Chief Economic Advisor, CEA. Sanjeev Sanyal is the current Principal Economic Advisor. Anurag Thakur is the State Ministry of Finance. So he is the State Ministry of Finance. And the Nirmala Sitharaman, she is the Minister of Finance. Okay. So moving to the next question. You have to tell that who has become the third Indian pacer to bag 300 test wickets. So who is that bowler? So tell me the answer. The options are given there: Stuart Broad, Jofra Archer, Ishant Sharma, James Anderson, or Dale Steyn. Friends, in such questions, if you don't know the correct answer, you can eliminate that. Question is asking about Indian pacer. So only Indian cricketer is Ishant Sharma. So Ishant Sharma will be the correct answer. But let me tell you that the Ishant Sharma became the third Indian pacer to bag 300 wickets. Other two pacers were Kapil Dev and Zahir Khan. Moving to the next question. As per Economic Survey GDP's estimation, what is the difference between real GDP and nominal GDP? What will be the correct answer? For this question, you must know the what is the value of real GDP and the nominal GDP, then only you can find the difference. So please tell what will be the correct answer, option A, B, C, or D. Friends, real GDP was 11%. So 11% has been estimated, and the nominal GDP has been estimated as 15.4% for the upcoming financial year. Okay, so the difference will be 4.4%. The difference between real GDP and nominal GDP is that inflation and price differences things are considered in nominal GDP. Moving to the next question, which of the following state has topped the Niti Aayog's Export Preparedness Index? Niti Aayog's EPI Index 2020. So your options are there. Which is the correct answer? You must remember that EPI has been released by Niti Aayog, and the CEO of Niti Aayog is Amitabh Kant. Okay. And who is the chairman of Niti Aayog? So chairman of Niti Aayog is ex officio, means Prime Minister of India. So right now, Narendra Modi is the chairman of Niti Aayog, and CEO is Amitabh Kant. So tell me the correct answer. So Gujarat is the correct answer. So Gujarat has topped the Niti Aayog's Export Preparedness Index 2020, followed by Maharashtra. So Maharashtra is second, and Tamil Nadu is third. Okay. And who is the vice chairman of Niti Aayog? So Amitabh Kant is the CEO of Niti Aayog, while Rajiv Kumar is the vice chairman of Niti Aayog. Okay. And basically, Niti Aayog is a policy think tank of Union Government, and this was established in 2015, means 2015. Moving to the next question. In which company the Union Government has decided to sell up to a 15% stake through an offer of for sale? So options are here. Which company is that? In which Union Government has decided to sell up to a 15% stake through an offer for sale? So remember the full form of OFS, it is offer for sale. The full form of IPO is initial public offering. So what is the correct answer? So the correct answer is Hindustan Aeronautics Limited, also known as HAL, HAL. Okay, so the government has decided to sell up to a 15% stake in Hindustan Aeronautics Limited through an OFS. So also the headquarter of this company is in Bangalore. Okay, moving on. India entered the top 50 innovating countries for the first time in 2020 since the inception of GII. What is GII? It is an index which tells about the innovation. So this is Global Innovation Index. So what is the rank of India? 48, 50, 52 or 54? Let me tell you about GII, means Global Innovation Index. So GII basically ranks the innovation performance of some 131 countries. Okay, and who releases this index? So this is co-published by WIPO and Cornell University and INSEAD University, which is a very good MBA college, Cornell and INSEAD. Comment in the comment box. Just must write in the comment box that where is the headquarter of WIPO, WIPO, and what is the full form of WIPO. This is the first question for you. So for this question, the correct answer is 48, means option number A. Moving on, which state government has announced a complete ban on organizing any religious and cultural meetings in the state till 30th September 2020? So which was this state? So only BJP can, UP can take such kind of stringent action. UP is the correct answer. Moving on. Who will be the CEO, means Chief Executive Officer of Amazon after Jeff Bezos? So you better know that Jeff Bezos will act as Executive Director after some months. Then who will take the position of Jeff Bezos? Who is that great person? So the correct answer is Andrew Jassy. He currently leads the AWS, means Amazon Web Services. Also, he has an MBA degree from Harvard Business School. Moving on. As per economic survey, India's GDP is estimated to Question number 9. As per economic survey, India's GDP is estimated to contract by 10% in the financial year 2020-21, means FY21. So what will be the correct answer? Options are given there. So the correct answer is 7.7%, means the contraction of 7.7% will occur in financial year 21. Okay, let me tell you that it was estimated that the contraction in first half will be 15.7% decline, and in the second half there will be a contraction of 0.1%, means modest fall of 0.1%. So cumulatively it was estimated that the contraction of 7.7% will happen in financial year 21. Also, a very important data was released yesterday by Ministry of Statistical and Program Implementation, means MOSPY. And what was that? In that data, it has been said that India's GDP will, it was about quarter three data. So it was said that India's GDP grows 0.4% in quarter three. Okay, so 0.4% positive, a growth of 0.4% in quarter three. Also, it has been estimated that in financial year 21, GDP will contract by 8%. So this is the data of NSO or MOSPY. Okay, so this is very important. Moving on. Question number 10. Economic survey constructs a DAS index at rural, urban and all India level with 26 indicators on 5 dimensions: water, sanitation, housing, micro environment and other facilities. So you have to tell that a new index has been introduced by Economic Survey of India. So what is the name of that index? Options are given there. What is the name of index? The correct answer is Bare Necessities Index. So it has been said that India has done a far better on these 5 dimensions, means water, sanitation, housing, microenvironment and other facilities. Moving to the next question, question number 11. As per economic survey, the recovery rate for the scheduled commercial banks through IBC has been over 10%. So what is the correct answer? Very important question. Friends, do you know the current number of PSBs? The current number of public sector banks in India is 12. Okay, after the merger and all. So coming to this question, the correct answer is 45%. Okay, so basically what is IBC? This is Insolvency and Bankruptcy Code. It came in 2016. So this is the inception year of IBC. And this law seeks to consolidate the existing framework by creating a single law for insolvency and bankruptcy. And through this, the recovery rate has been 45%. Okay. Moving to the next question. Department of Science and Technology, means DSD, has launched a DAS job portal for mapping the skills of workers. What is the name of that portal, which has been released by Department of Science and टेक्नोलॉजी। सो द नेम ऑफ दैट पोर्टल इज सक्षम पोर्टल। मूविंग टू द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, नेशनल प्रोडक्टिविटी डे इज ऑब्जर्व ऑन। वेरी बेसिक क्वेश्चन, यू जस्ट हैव टू सेलेक्ट द करेक्ट डेट। सो द नेशनल प्रोडक्टिविटी डे इज February 12, ऑप्शन नंबर सी। क्वेश्चन नंबर 14, नेम द पायोनियर कंप्यूटर डिजाइनर एंड एन इनोवेटिव इंजीनियर हु वाज पास्ड अवे एट द एज ऑफ 103। सो इन सच क्वेश्चन नो नीड टू डू एनीथिंग एक्स्ट्रा। सो द करेक्ट आंसर इज एंड्रू स्पीलबर्ग। सो बेसिकली ही हैज पायोनियर द कंप्यूटर डिजाइनिंग एंड ही वाज अ वेरी इनोवेटिव इंजीनियर। क्वेश्चन नंबर 15, हु हैज बिकम द फर्स्ट एवर इंडिविजुअल टू हिट अ नेट वर्थ ऑफ $200 बिलियन। सो हु इज दैट पर्सन? सो ही इज द फाउंडर एंड सीईओ ऑफ अमेजॉन, मीन्स जेफ बेजोस। सो जेफ बेजोस बिकम द फर्स्ट एवर इंडिविजुअल टू हिट अ नेट वर्थ ऑफ $200 बिलियन। एंड एट द सेकेंड स्पॉट देयर इज इलॉन मस्क एंड समटाइम्स बिल गेट्स। So we can't say that currently who is at the top position because it fluctuates every time. Someday it is Elon Musk, someday it is Jeff Bezos. But the Jeff Bezos was the first person to hit a net worth of $200 billion. Question number 16, Commerce and Industry Minister Das has virtually launched a first of its kind GIS enabled national land bank portal. So who is the Commerce and Industry Minister of India? So the correct answer is Piyush Goyal. Okay, so basically Piyush Goyal virtually launched a first of its kind GIS enabled national land bank portal. So what this portal will do? This portal will help investors zero in on land located in various states for potential projects. Okay, so many potential projects can be started. Who is the governor of current governor of Puducherry? Previously Kiran Bedi was the governor of Puducherry, but you have to tell who is the current governor of Puducherry. The correct answer is option A, Tamilsai Sundarajan. Okay, moving to the next question. HP India and DAS have announced a collaboration to provide scientifically designed worksheets and content to support home learning. So with which institutions has HP collaborated? The correct answer is NSDC, means National Skill Development Corporation. Question number 19, Labor Ministry aims to implement 4 labor codes from April 1. Sri Santosh Gangwar is the Labour Minister. You have to tell that he is the Member of Parliament from which constituency. So the correct answer is, okay, Bareilly, Uttar Pradesh. Question number 20, recently Tata Group purchases 68% ownership of which delivery app? It was either Swiggy, Zomato, Grofers or Big Basket. So the correct answer is Big Basket. The CEO of Zomato is Deepinder Goyal. It was asked in a recent examination, Deepinder Goyal. And the CEO of Swiggy is Srihars Majeti. And the CEO of Make My Trip is Deep Kalra. Moving on. Which state launched Knowledge Mission, which aims to transform the state into a knowledge economy? So the correct answer is Kerala. Okay. Recently, Kerala government presented their budget in which these things were told. So moving to the next question, and who is the CM of Kerala? CM of Kerala is Pinari Vijayan. So basically he launched this mission. Name the Ramtari Ganga Mali actor who has passed away recently. Very easy question. What will be the correct answer? So the correct answer is Rajiv Kapoor, option D. Okay, so Ramtari Ganga Mali actor Rajiv Kapoor has passed away recently. Unfinished, a memoir is authored by which person? So which person has authored this book named as Unfinished? So the correct answer is Priyanka Chopra, option C. Moving on, question number 24, which organization releases the Doing Business Report, DPR? Options are AIIB, IMF, World Bank, WTO or OECD. So who releases the Doing Business Report? So the correct answer is option C, World Bank. So the headquarters of World Bank is in USA. So the US-based World Bank has posted the DBR, which carries the EODB ranking. So basically this report, DBR, carries the EODB ranking, which is Ease of Doing Business ranking. Okay, and David Malpass is the current present president of the World Bank. Moving on to question number 25. As per economic survey, India's ranking HDI means Human Development Index was recorded at dash out of a total 189 countries. So what is the rank of India in HDI? The correct answer is option B, 131. So rank of India is 131 out of 189 countries. Write in comment box that who stood at rank 1 in HDI index. Question number 26. India's first geothermal power project will be established at Puga village of which place? So which will be the correct answer? India's first geothermal power project will be established at Puga village of, so the correct answer is Ladakh. Okay. Moving on, ICC has signed Indian EdTech startup as a global partner for 3 years. What is the name of that EdTech startup? It is a no-brainer. Byju's is the answer. And recently, Sachin Tendulkar became the brand ambassador of an academy. Okay. Question number 28. Name the actor who played Black Panther in the Marvel Cinematic Universe was passed away recently. So what will be the correct answer of question number 28? Option A is the correct answer. So Chadwick Boseman played the character of Black Panther. So he passed away recently. Question number 29. Union Minister of Electronics and Information Technology has launched DAS, Next Generation Startup Challenge Contest, to boost startups and software products with a special focus on Tier 2 towns of India. So what is the name of that contest? Name of that contest is Chunauti. Option D. Okay. And Mr. Ravi Shankar Prasad is present, Union Minister for Electronics and IT. Now NIC means National Informatics Center and MeitY is developing a WhatsApp-like app. What is the name of that app? So the name of that app is Sandesh. SNDES Sandesh. Who won the Australian Open in the female category? Maria Sharapova, Naomi Osaka or Serena Williams? So Naomi Osaka won the Australian Open in the female category and she is from Japan. 32. Which country will be buying the businesses from the Future Group for ₹24,713 crores? Which company will you buy the business from the Future Group? So what will be the correct answer? Very simple question this is. So the correct answer is option B, Reliance Retail. So Reliance Retail will be buying the businesses of the Future Group, and Reliance Venture is the subsidiary of Reliance India Industries Limited, and the CEO of Future Group. So question number 33. Indian ASEAN countries agreed to review the FTA to make it more user friendly, simple and facilitative recently. What is the full form of FTA? The full form of FTA is option E, Free Trade Agreement. Okay. And where is the headquarter of ASEAN? So headquarter of ASEAN is in Jakarta, Indonesia. Jakarta, Indonesia. Okay. And what are the countries of ASEAN? Not so important. Just remember the headquarter of means ASEAN, that is Jakarta, Indonesia. And the full form of ASEAN is Association of South East Asian Nations, means this is an association of Southeast Asian Nations. Moving on, India is withdrawing from multilateral military exercise Caucasus 2020 to be held in, so correct answer is Russia, Caucasus 2020. How many times had Novak Djokovic won the Australian Open title? So Djokovic had won this title for 9 times, and he is from Serbia. The capital of Serbia is Belgrade. Name India's own microblogging platform to counter Twitter. The correct answer is Ku. The CEO of Twitter is Jack Dorsey. Question 37. ISA means International Solar Alliance has announced Dr. Ajay Mathur as its new DG. Where is the headquarter of ISA? The correct answer is Gurugram, Haryana. Who is the new Italian Prime Minister? So you have to tell that who is the new Italian Prime Minister. The options are given here. So the correct option is option C, Mario Draghi. Okay. Moving on, question number 39. Which state will set up India's first international women's trade center in consonance with UN SDG? So which state will set up India's first World Trade Center with the help of UN? So the correct answer is option B, Kerala. So Kerala will set up India's first international World Trade Women's Trade Center. And at which place? So the name of place is Engamali. Engamali and this is in Kochi. Moving on, the 15th Finance Commission has reduced vertical devolution to states to 10% from 42%. Very simple question. This is answer is 41%. Okay, and the chairman of 15th Finance Commission is N.K. Singh, Nandkishore Singh. Moving on, the RBI sets up a panel to suggest strengths for strengthening consolidation of UCBs, means urban cooperative banks. So who will head the committee? The correct answer is option number D, means N.S. Viswanathan. Question number 42. Digital payments platform PhonePe had partnered with Axis Bank on a UPI multi-bank model. So the PhonePe app is based on the which technology, means which interface? Very simple question, UPI. And the full form of UPI is Unified Payment Index, Payment Interface, Unified Payments Interface. So you must remember the full form of UPI, very important. Okay, moving on. Which bank will provide $400 million to the Maldives to fund the Greater Mail Connectivity project? What will be the correct answer, A, B, C, D, or E? So anytime you see such questions in which any loan is being given to any foreign countries, so the answer will be Exim Bank, means Export Import Bank of India. As the name suggests, it export import, so you can guess that this will be the correct answer. So the Exim Bank is the correct answer. Moving to the next question. Mandu Festival is celebrated in which state? So Mandu is celebrated in Madhya Pradesh. Okay. Moving to the next question. Where is the headquarter of International Finance Service Center Authority, means IFSCA? So where is the headquarter of IFSCA? This was asked in SBI PO. So the headquarter is in Gandhinagar, Gujarat. Chandrayaan 3 mission will be executed in which year? What will be the correct answer? When Chandrayaan 3 will be executed? So this will be executed in December 2021. Okay. Question number 47. The contingency fund of India is to be augmented from rupees 10 crore to rupees 30 crore through finance bill. So the what will be the correct answer? What is the correct answer? The correct answer is 500 crore, means option C. Moving on. 48. Which of the following is to be launched by NSIL, means New Space India Limited, carrying Brazil's Amazonia satellite and some Indian satellites? So correct answer is PSLV CS-51. Very important question. Moving on. 49. FDI limits in the insurance sector has been increased from 49% to 10%. So this is the first question, that what is the new FDI limit in insurance sector, and then budget outlays asset reconstruction company ARC. This was asked in the recent IAPS exam. And asset management company AMC to be set up rupee dash crore carry capitalization of PSB disinvestments in BE 2020-21. BE means budget estimate. So the before estimate, so the what will be the correct answer? So there are two questions, new FDI limit of insurance sector and the recapitalization of PSBs. Currently there are 12 PSBs in India, public sector bank. So the correct answer will be option A. So new FDI each in insurance sector is 74%, and recapitalization of 20,000 crore was done in public sector banks. Question number 50. Mitra scheme is related to which sector? So Mitra sector scheme is related to textiles. Okay, textiles. Moving on. What are the estimated receipts from disinvestment in BE 2020-21? So you have to tell the correct answer. What is the estimated receipt from disinvestment target? So the correct answer is 1.75 trillion. Moving to the next question. Rupees 1.97 lakh crore in the next 5 years for PLI scheme, means productivity linked incentive scheme, in dash sectors. Now how many sectors this money will be distributed? The right answer is 13 sector. Who is the youngest American in space on Elon Musk SpaceX rocket? So the youngest man in space will be Halley Arfaniex. India on Monday offered a 100 million line of credit to Mauritius to facilitate the procurement of defense asset. Name the Mauritius Prime Minister. So Pravind Jagannath is the correct answer. Moving on. Name the fighter controller for Perseverance Mars rover of NASA. So Sivaj Swati Mohan. Okay, Perseverance is the 9th spacecraft to land on Mars, means red planet. Also it will collect rock samples to find the existence of microscopic life. Question number 56. RBI said it has barred Karnataka based Dakkan Urban Cooperative Bank from granting fresh loans or accepting deposits and customer cannot withdraw more than rupees dash from their saving accounts for a period of 6 months. So what is that limit up to which a customer cannot withdraw? So customer cannot withdraw more than rupees 1000. Option number A is the correct one. Okay, so and the headquarter, this is Deccan Urban Cooperative Bank, is Karnataka based. So just remember this fact. Moving on, name the person known as Metro Man for developing Delhi Metro, now joining BJP Kerala. So the Metro Man of India is none other than E. Sridharan. Okay, moving to the next question. Diwan Housing Finance Corporation, DHFL, suffering from bankruptcy, RBI has cleared which of the following group to buy this entity? So the correct answer is Piramal. So RBI has allowed Piramal to buy this entity, Diwan Housing Finance Limited Finance Corporation. Chittora Jhil or Chittora Lake is located in which state? So the correct answer is Uttar Pradesh. Option B. Moving to the next question. Also, Suhail Dev Memorial is in Suhail Dev Memorial is also in Uttar Pradesh, Bahraich. Uttar Pradesh, Bahraich. This was in news because Narendra Modi laid the foundation stone of Suhail Dev Memorial and Chittora Lake's development work in Uttar Pradesh, Bahraich. Okay. World's biggest cricket stadium is located in, very simple one, Ahmedabad. Who relaxed technical norms on minimum public offer to facilitate LIC IPO? So who relaxed technical norms? What will be the correct answer? So anything which is related to a stock exchange or IPO is done by SEBI, means Securities Exchange Bank of Bureau of India. Option B. Which Indian city has been recognized as the 2023 city of the world? Very important question. So the correct answer is option A, Hyderabad. Okay. Moving to the next question. Who becomes the first bowler to dismiss left-handers 200 times in test cricket? So you have to name the first bowler who dismissed 200 times to the left-hander. So Ravichandran Aswin is the correct answer. Ravi Aswin. So basically he has become the first cricketer in 143 year history of test cricket to take 200 wicket of left-handed batsman. Okay. Moving to the next question. When is the World Day of Social Justice is observed? So World Day of Social Justice. Very important one. The correct answer is option C, February 21st. Okay. And what was the theme of this time? The theme was a call for social justice in the digital economy. A call for social justice in the digital economy. Digital economy. In PDF, everything is there. So you can refer that PDF also. Question number 65. As per the 15th Finance Commission, India now needs a DAS, new DAS. So what is that thing which is needed in India? So this is FRBMLO. So 15th Finance Commission says that India now needs a new FRBMLO because of some many reasons, not important for phase one. Question number 66. As per budget 21-22, the allocation for Jal Jeevan Mission will be ₹2,87,000 crore. Option B for over 5 years. Okay. Question number 67. And the Minister of Jal Shakti is Gajendra Singh Shekhawat. He's from Rajasthan. Question number 67. Which nation plans to have the first nuclear reactor on the moon by 2026? First nuclear reactor on the moon. So which country has set this audacious goal? So the name of that country is USA. Option E. Okay. So now we will move to the question number 68. When is the National Women's Day observed? The National Women's Day is observed on February 13th. And so let's move to the next question. 69. By what name in March 2021 will the Indian Navy commission its third Scorpene submarine? So what is the name of that third submarine? So the name of that is INS Karanj. Option B. Okay. And that's it. Moving to the next question. Which union minister launched the e-Chhauni portal recently? So Chhauni, as the name suggests, much related to something defense kind of thing. So Rajnath Singh is the correct answer. You can think in this way also. Okay. Chhauni is basically cantonments where defense personnel live. Question number 71. Who has been appointed as the new chief of WTO, World Trade Organization? So who is the next new chief? The name is option C. Very difficult name, Ngozi Okonjo-Iweala, and she is from Nigeria, and she will take over the position of next chief of WTO, World Trade Organization. Friends, where is the headquarter of WTO? Do you know?
The headquarters of WTO is in Geneva, Switzerland. Okay, and it was founded in 1995. Moving to the question number 72, with which state government did Tata Electronics sign an MOU to establish its facility for the manufacture of mobile component? So, which is the correct answer? So, the Tata Electronics signed an MOU with Tamil Nadu to establish its facility for manufacturing mobile components. So, the Tamil Nadu will be the correct answer. Moving to the question number 73, very easy question. Kalaripattu is a martial art that originated in, the correct answer is Kerala. So, Kalaripattu is associated with Kerala. What is the capital of Bahrain? So, the capital of Bahrain is Manama. Okay, and what is the currency of Bahrain? You have to tell the currency of Bahrain. Do you know? So, the capital of Bahrain is Manama. Bahrain is Manama, while the currency is Dinar. Okay, D-I-N-A-R, Dinar. The Banking Regulation Bill 2020 was brought to empower DAS to restructure cooperative banks. So, what is the correct answer? So, the BR Bill 2020 was brought to empower the Reserve Bank of India. RBI will be the correct answer. Moving to the question number 76. A Sfoorti scheme is under the aegis of which ministry? A Sfoorti scheme. So, if you know the full form of a Sfoorti scheme, you can basically guess. So, the full form of a Sfoorti is a scheme of fund for regeneration of traditional industries. A scheme of fund for regeneration of traditional industries. The correct answer is Ministry of Rural Development. Now, question 77. National Science Day is celebrated on 28th Feb every year. What is the reason behind the celebration of National Science Day? Very easy question. The invention of Raman effect by C.V. Raman. Okay. Question 78. TROPICS is being held at which place? TROPICS, Theater Level Operational Readiness Exercise. What is the correct answer? The correct answer is option A, Sriharikota. And let me tell you that this is the largest exercise conducted by Indian Navy. Okay. Moving to the next place, next question. Nai Roshni scheme has been launched by which ministry? So Nai Roshni, this is basically leadership development program for minority women. So the answer will be Ministry of Minority Affairs, because it helps minority women, and the Minister of Minority Affairs is Mukhtar Abbas Naqvi. Question number 80. Minimum age to open an individual bank account is 18 years. This is not given. Correct answer is 18 years. Friends, you can subscribe our full course for RBI Grade B. And so let's move to the another 80 questions. Question number 1. Consider the following statements about COVID-19 performance index. 1. It is released by the WHO. New Zealand is the best performing nation. India has been ranked 86th on the index. This is a tough question. Kindly guess what will be the correct answer. COVID-19 performance index. What will be the correct answer? Option A, B, C, D, or E. This is another part of this video. We have discussed 80 questions, and now we will discuss another 80 questions, and then after we will discuss 40 questions. In totality, 200 questions will be completed. So the correct answer is option D. All are correct. Okay. So basically, this index was compiled by Sydney-based Lowy Institute. So must remember that Lowy Institute is in Sydney. This is an Australian think tank which sought to measure the response of countries to the pandemic. New Zealand stood at top, while India was at 86th on the index. Moving on, the Great Reset Initiative recently seen in the news is launched by which country? The Great Reset Initiative. So this was launched by World Economic Forum, option D. Okay. Moving on, the Union Minister of Health and Family Welfare addressed the fourth edition of the Future Investment Initiative Forum, FII, but it is described as Davos in the desert. So you have to tell that FII is a flagship initiative of which country? So FII is a flagship initiative of Saudi Arabia. Question number 4. Basically, it is 84th. So, India Justice Report. Which state has the highest percentage of women public officers? Very tough question. The correct answer is Tamil Nadu. So, तमिलनाडु हैज हाइएस्ट परसेंटेज ऑफ वीमेन पब्लिक ऑफिसर्स, ओके मस्ट रिमेंबर पब्लिक ऑफिसर्स, वाइल महाराष्ट्र वॉज रैंक्ड टॉप मोस्ट अमंग 18 स्टेट्स फॉर द सेकंड टाइम इन अ रो. सो महाराष्ट्र वॉज रैंक्ड फर्स्ट इन इंडिया जस्टिस रिपोर्ट. एंड इन कैटेगरी ऑफ वीमेन पब्लिक ऑफिसर्स तमिलनाडु टॉप्ड, ओके. बिहार और बिहार लीड्स द लिस्ट ऑफ 25 स्टेट्स फॉर एम्प्लॉइंग मोस्ट वीमेन इट्स पुलिस फोर्स. इफ वी आस्क अबाउट वीमेन रेशियो इन पुलिस फोर्स, मीन्स वीमेन रेशियो इन पुलिस फोर्स, नॉट वीमेन पुलिस ऑफिसर. सो हाइएस्ट परसेंटेज ऑफ वीमेन पुलिस इज इन बिहार, द परसेंटेज 25.3%, मीन्स इन, ओके. क्वेश्चन नंबर 5, रिसेंटली पाकिस्तान रिसीव द जी टैग फॉर इट्स बासमती राइस. जी आई इज गवर्न बाई WTO एग्रीमेंट ऑन ट्रिप्स. फॉर्म ऑफ ट्रिप्स इज ट्रेड रिलेटेड एस्पेक्ट्स ऑफ इंटेलेक्चुअल प्रॉपर्टी राइट्स. Where the headquarter of WTO, we recently discussed, we just discussed the headquarter of WTO is in Geneva, Switzerland. The sovereign gold bond scheme seeks to encourage people to buy gold bonds instead of actual gold. Who issues these bonds on behalf of the central government? Very simple question. So the RBI issues these bonds on behalf of the central government. Option B is correct. B, RBI. The Global Financial Stability Report is released by who releases this report? Global Financial Stability. Very easy question. It is released by IMF, International Monetary Fund, IMF. Okay. And there is another report named as Investment Trend Monitor Report. Means Investment Trends Monitor Report, which tells about the trends of investment in the world. It is released by UNCTAD. UNCTAD. Okay. And what were the highlights of this report? This report was released recently. So India witnessed a 13% year-on-year rise, the highest among key nations. Means India, in percentage terms, India topped the FDI inflows in 2020. Okay. China rose by 4% while India rose by 13%. Moving on. The latest World Economic Forum of the IMF has estimated that India's GDP will grow by 10% in FY22. As per IMF, the estimated GDP is 11.5%, option C. Question number 9, which award is highest in the hierarchy of Padma Awards? So the correct answer is Padma Vibhushan. Bharat Ratna is the highest Indian award, but in Padma Awards, Padma Vibhushan is at the highest position. Garia Puja is a festival of, so Garia Puja is a festival of Tripura, option A. Okay, moving to the next question. Which of the following ministry has launched Shram Shakti? This is a national migration support portal to smooth the formulation of states and state and national level programs for migrant workers. So which ministry is responsible for that? Correct answer is Ministry of Tribal Affairs. Okay. A large scale joint military exercise DAS involving assets of all three forces, means Army, Navy and Air Force, also Indian Coast Guard, is being conducted under the aegis of Andaman and Nicobar Island. So what is the name of that exercise? This is Kavach, option C. Okay, this will involve Army, Navy, Air Force as well as Coast Guard. Question number 13. The central government has decided to observe Subhash Chandra Bose Jayanti as Dash Divas to be celebrated on 23rd January. So Parakram Divas is the answer. Parakram Divas. Samarpan Divas is associated with Deen Dayal Upadhyay's anniversary. Deen Dayal Upadhyay. Moving to the next question. Which of the following tiger reserve is not located in Madhya Pradesh? So the correct answer is Nagarjuna, Sri Salem. Reddest all tiger reserves is there in Madhya Pradesh, Kanha, Panna, Pinch and Satpura. And where is the this Nagarjuna Sagar, Sri Salem? This tiger reserve is in Telangana. And let me tell you, Telangana. And this is the largest tiger reserve of India. Nagarjuna, Sri Salem is the largest tiger reserve of India. Question 15. India has inked a strategic partnership agreement with the IEA, means International Energy Agency. You have to tell the headquarter of IEA, means where is the headquarter of International Energy Agency? So this is in Paris, France. Option A. Moving on, cabinet approved 5000 crore investment for Rattle hydro power project on Chenab River in Rattle hydro project in Jammu Kashmir. Option B is correct. Okay. Now moving to the next question. Indian Air Force and French Air and Space Force will conduct a bilateral exercise known as exercise Desert Night 21 at. So this exercise will be held at Jodhpur. Jodhpur is in Rajasthan. Moving on. India Innovation Index 2020 was released by Niti Aayog. Which state topped in the major state category? So We have to tell the answer. So Karnataka top with this index. Karnataka very important as question. So India Innovation Index report by Niti Aayog, and Karnataka topped this index in the major state category. Okay. First bird festival was observed at Nag Natki Bird Sanctuary. Nagi Natki Bird Sanctuary. And what are the name of the bird festival? The name of bird festival was Kalarau. This was held in Bihar. Okay. The chief minister of Bihar is Nitish Kumar from JDU, means Janata Dal United. Moving to the next question. India has ranked 85th in the most powerful passport report, Henley Passport Index. Which country topped? Very simple question. So Japan topped this index. Moving to the question number 21. This is a tough question about UNSC. So you have to tell which statement is correct. Okay. And the three statements is given there. So let me tell you that all are correct. UNSC consists of 5 permanent and 10 non-permanent countries members, and this is important one, that India has entered as a non-permanent member of UNSC for the 8th time. Okay. Pradhan Mantri Fasal Bima Yojana has completed dash year of its launch. So PMFBY was launched on 13th January 2016. So it completed 5 years. 13th Jan 2016 was its inception year. Whose birth date is celebrated as the National Youth Day? Viriji Swami Vivekananda. Swami Vivekananda is the correct answer. And the guru of Swami Vivekananda was Ramakrishna Paramahansa. This day was celebrated on February 12. And the theme of this year was Yuva Utsah Naye Bharat Ka, means Yuva Utsah Naye Bharat Ka. Just remember this keyword Yuva, Yuva and Utsah. Which country has landed first ever nuclear powered reactor rover on moon? So who is that country? Basically USA has landed its first nuclear powered reactor rover on moon. So option C is the correct answer. Moving to the question number 25. Which fintech platform, payment platform, closed its operation in India? So the correct answer is PayPal. Okay. So headquarters of PayPal is in California, USA. And the founder name of Joho is Sridhar Vembu. He was awarded with the Padma Award this year. Going to question number 26. National Science Day is celebrated on. We just saw. Very easy question. So National Science Day is celebrated on. Option A, Feb 28. Which country has regained its position as the top trading partner of India in 2020? So China regained its position. At the second position, it was USA. Question 28. Irak Ali Garib Ashwali has been elected as the new PM of Georgia. What is the currency of Georgia? A very tough name. Irak Ali, just remember the keyword. The currency of Georgia is Lari. And the capital is Tbilisi. This is capital. And Lari is currency. Very important. Question 29. Vishnu Narayan Nabamurthy passed away recently. She was a well-known. So what is the profession? She was a well-known poet. Option C. Moving on. FATF decided to keep Pakistan on its terrorism financing grey list. Where is the headquarter of FATF? So headquarter of FATF is in Paris, France. Okay. Moving to the next question. Question number 31. Nirmala Sitharaman participated virtually in the first G20 financial ministers and the central bank governors meeting under the presidency of which country? So the correct answer is Italy. Yusuf Pathan retired from all format. He was associated with which sport? So Yusuf Pathan was a cricketer. He was an all-rounder, brother of Irfan Pathan. 33. Government has signed a $304 million loan with AIIB for strengthening the electricity transmission system of which state? So the correct answer is option A, Assam. Okay. The CM of Assam is Sarbanand Sonowal. Capital is Dispur. And where is the headquarter of AIIB? Means Asian Infrastructure Bank. So AIIB headquarters in it is in China, and the exact place is I cannot recall right now. It is Beijing. The AIIB headquarters is Beijing. Okay, I will confirm you within some time. Moving to the next question. The Reserve Bank of India has brought which bank under its regulatory purview? So the right answer is State Bank of Sikkim. Okay. Moving on, and yes, the headquarter of AIIB is Beijing, China. Question 35. India's polar rocket on Sunday successfully launched the Amazonia 1 satellite from the spaceport here in the mission of the year for Space Agency, in the first mission of the year for ISRO. So Amazonia 1 satellite was of, I think it was from of Brazil. Yes, the answer is Brazil. Moving on to the next question. It is about Olympic. So Indian Olympic Committee has named Brisbane, Australia as the preferred bidder to host the 2032 Olympic Games. Where is the headquarter of IOC, means headquarter of International Olympic Committee? Very important question. The headquarter is in Lausanne. And where is Lausanne? It is in Switzerland. Also Geneva is in Switzerland. Question number 37. In which state second edition of the Winter Sports Festival under Khelo India has been started? The answer is Gulmarg, Jammu and Kashmir. Also Jammu and Kashmir topped this festival. Hima Das was a renowned sprinter inducted as a DSP in which state's police? The correct answer is option B, Assam. Name the Indian who has been appointed as the UN's Assistant Secretary General, means United Nations Assistant Secretary General. So the right answer is option C, means Ligia Noronha. So C has been appointed. Moving on, question number 40. The government has lifted the embargo on private sector banks for the conduct of government related banking transactions. RBI carries out the banking general banking business through agency bank under section dash of the RBI Act 1934. So through which act RBI carries the general banking business? So the correct answer is, very easy question this is, the correct answer is section 45, option C. So now every private sector bank, government has lifted the embargo of private sector banks to conduct the government related banking transaction. Earlier only some of the private sector bank used to do the government related banking transaction. Now any private bank can do such kind of thing. Okay, so moving to the next question. What is the validity of DD, means demand draft? Very easy question, this is 3 months. Moving on, Upul Tharanga retired, he was from Sri Lanka and he was a cricketer. Moving on, ADB has appointed Wong Chung Am as MD, managing director in general. So where is the headquarter of ADB? So it is in Mandaluyong, and Mandaluyong is in Philippines. Okay, and what is the capital of Philippines? The capital of Philippines is Manila. Okay, and the capital of Vietnam is Hanoi. Exim Bank has extended a 100 million loan to which country on behalf of India for defense related procurement? So Exim Bank keep distributing loans in some or another form, not very important. Okay, but for the sake of question, let me tell you that the Mauritius is the answer. And what is more important than that is capital of Mauritius. Capital of Mauritius is Male. It is Male or Port Louis. I am not clear. I think this is Male. Okay, so Male is the correct answer. Sorry, capital of Mauritius is Port Louis. Capital of Maldives is Male. I also got confused. The Port Louis is the capital of Maldives, and the currency is Mauritian rupee. Okay, and the Prime Minister of Mauritius is Pravind Jagannauth. Moving on, IT Madras dairy tech startup Stella has signed a pact with which bank to digitize milk procurement? Okay, so this is a news related from IT. It becomes important. So the correct answer is IPPB, means India Post Payment Bank. Moving on, and the CEO of Payment Bank is Venkatramu. Which country hosts the first meeting of the BRICS Finance and Central Bank Deputies of 2021? India. This is the correct answer. Don't confuse it with Italy and other kind of thing. That was another question. Question number 47. Which bank has been included in the second schedule of the RBI Act 1934 recently? So the first bank, so the Fino Paytm Bank is the correct answer. So this bank has been included in the, this is the first Paytm Bank, I think, which has been included in the second schedule of the Reserve Bank of India. So earlier it was just like a small finance bank. So this was converted into the, means earlier this was payment bank, and this has been converted into a full-fledged bank, I think. Moving to the next question. Tamil Nadu CM E. Palaniswamy inaugurated the Asia's biggest cattle park in which district? And the correct answer is Salem. Okay, option C. So option C is the correct answer. Moving on. Who has assumed the charge of chairman of National Commission for Scheduled castes? Okay, correct answer is option D, Vijay Sampala. He is now the chairman of NCSC. Moving to the next question, question number 50. Ankita Raina is associated with which sports? So she is associated with tennis. Option B. Next question, with which country Mahindra, with which company Mahindra Electric have entered a partnership for the deployment of electric three wheelers for last mile delivery? So Mahindra has collaborated with Amazon. Option C. 2020 Individual Wrestling World Cup will be held in. So the World Cup will be held in Serbia. Option C, D, Serbia. Question number, next question, which bank opens a representative office in Nepal? So the correct answer is ICICI. So ICICI opened a representative office in Nepal. 520 megawatt hydropower power project damaged in glacier burst and floods of which firm? So NTPC in Uttarakhand. This accident took place. And the largest toy manufacturer cluster is in which state? So Karnataka. Recently, international toy festival was inaugurated virtually by PM Modi. So this is in Karnataka. 1% company residency limit has been reduced to what days? So 120 days. Option C. CEO of Twitter is Jack Dorsey. Vitalik Buterin is the CEO of Ethereum cryptocurrency. Pavel Durov is the CEO of Telegram app. And Mark Zuckerberg is the CEO of Facebook, Instagram and WhatsApp. And Satoshi Nakamoto, he was the inventor of Bitcoin. Okay, now question 458. World's largest renewable energy park opens in. So what will be the correct answer? Can you guess? The correct answer is Kutch, Gujarat. So world's largest renewable energy park will be in Kutch, Gujarat. Question number 59. Name the countries whose central bank has got 1 million followers on Twitter. India, RBI. What is the first T in the full form of TLTRO? So TLTRO is targeted long term repo operation. So answer will be targeted. Retail investors can open DAS accounts with the banking and monetary policy regulator, giving direct access to them in investing in the primary and secondary government bond market. The primary market is basically IPO and secondary market is stock and share market. Okay, so answer is gilt account. What is the current CRR rate? So the current CRR rate is 3%. Economic survey says DAS SAP recovery expected. So GDP means V SAP recovery, and as per economic survey, the GDP forecast is 11%. IMF 11.5%, and from RBI it is 10.5%. In which district Chief Minister Sarbanand Sonowal led the foundation of first skill university of Eastern India? So the correct answer is Darang. World Water Day theme is valuing water. When this day will be observed? Option D, March 22. Kaziranga National Park and Majuli Island is in. It is in Assam. Recently, a month-long strawberry festival was begun in Jhansi Bundelkhand, UP, Uttar Pradesh. When will India host the G20 summit? India will host G20 summit in 2023. Okay. Now we will move to the question number 69. Moving on, mutual funds in India is regulated by. So who regulates mutual fund in India? It is regulated by SEBI. Okay. So option B will be correct. Moving to the next question. Government of India shareholding percentage in NABARD is. So Government of India holds 100% of NABARD. So option C is correct. Okay. Basically, RBI divested its entire stake in NABARD and NHB, means National Housing Bank, amounting to rupees 20 crore and 1450 crore respectively. With this, Government of India hold now 100% stake in NABARD. Irfan Khan's first film, The Warrior. Option A. FASTag employs DASH technology. Which technology? It is RFID, radio frequency identification. Center of Wetland Conservation and Management set up in Chennai. Wetland Conservation and Management. ICC Men's T20 Player of the Year. T20 Player. This is Rashid Khan. World Tourism Organization Headquarter. So World Tourism Headquarter. There is two WTO. One is World Trade Organization and second is World Tourism Organization. So you better know that the headquarter of WTO means World Trade Organization in Geneva, okay, Switzerland. But the headquarter of WTO, this WTO is in Madrid. And Madrid is where? It is in Spain. Madrid is in Spain or Italy. I am getting confused. Madrid. 1 minute. Yes, this is in Spain. Moving on. Bhavana Kant is related to which state? The correct answer is Bihar. Who released the India's first field ready electric tractor, Tiger Electric? The answer is Sonalika. Name the Indian company that is world's most valuable and strongest IT services brand with a record brand value of $26 billion. So what is the name of that IT company? So as it is asking about world's most valuable, so Accenture will be the answer. And okay, but in Indian case it is TCS. Moving to the next question. Member assembly of the West Bengal count is 294. What is the member assembly of Tamil Nadu? So this is 224. It can be asked. According to the UNESCO, which country hawker culture represents community dining and culinary practices in a multilateral urban context? So the answer is Singapore. Now we move to the, we have discussed 160 questions yet. Now we'll see our last 40 questions of this video. Question number 14. India likely to grow DAS next year by Moody. So what is the GDP estimation by Moody? This is 13.7%. Okay. RBI so far this fiscal has purchased over rupees dash trillion of central and state government bonds from the secondary market to provide liquidity to the system. Can you guess what will be the correct answer? I'm giving you some time. So the correct answer is option C, 3 million. Okay. Currently, the 10-year bond yields remain flat at 6.16%. Not so important, but it might be asked in examination. Question 16. Federal Bank headquarters. So Federal Bank just launched a scheme Federal 247, and the headquarters of Federal Bank is in Aluva, Kerala. Option A. Which bank launches the Namma Chennai Smart Card? So ICICI started Namma Chennai Smart Card. Which bank joins JP Morgan's blockchain-based payment system? SBI is the correct answer. State Bank of India. As in the process to set up a new ARC gather system, which bank has begun the process to exit ARC, also known as ARCIL, RCIL. So Punjab National Bank is the correct answer. Okay, so moving to the next question now. DBS Lakshmi Vilas Bank acquisition was the first time the RBI turned to a foreign lender to bail out a local bank. Where is the headquarter of DBS Bank? The headquarter of DBS Bank is in Singapore. Option A. RBI puts rupees 1000 withdrawal cap on Deccan Urban Cooperative Bank. Where is the headquarter of Deccan Urban Cooperative Bank? And this is the Karnataka based bank, so and the headquarter of this bank is in Bangalore, Karnataka. Moving to the question number 22. In 2010-19, the government had given the controlling stake in IDBI Bank to insurance Behemoth LIC. And in 2020, 10 public sector banks were consolidated into 6 big size banks. You have just to tell the current number of public sector banks in India. It was 27 in 2017, but now it is only 12. Okay. So moving to the next question. Which bank continued to witness the highest failure rate for UPI transaction? This is United Union Bank of India. This bank topped. Which bank has entered into a strategic partnership with the fintech company Vayana Network to offer channel financing services for MSME? So the correct answer is Bank of Maharashtra. Option C. Moving to the question number 25. MDR. So the definition of MDR is given. MDR is the fee that a merchant pays to a bank for facilitating a digital transaction. What is the full form of MDR means? What is D in MDR? So full form of MDR is merchant discount rate. So option D will be the correct answer. Moving to merchant discount rate. Moving. What is T in the full form of NCLT? So recently, Amazon urges NCLT not to allow Future Group, means Kishore Biyani Group, shareholders to meet. The full form of NCLT is National Company Law Tribunal, so T is Tribunal, okay. And there is also a NCLAT, so in NCLAT, that is National Company Appellate Law Tribunal. So everything is same like NCLT, just in NCLAT means in NCLAT, A means Appellate, Appellate, okay. So moving on, India recorded $1,422 million US dollar FDI inflow from DAS in 2019-2020 by as per Grant Thornton report. So what is the correct answer? So UK, option B, 28. Recently, who permitted resident individuals to make remittances under the LRS, some is important limit liberalized remittance scheme, to IFSC in the country. IFSC full form is also important. So what is the correct answer? The correct answer is Reserve Bank of India, RBI. Okay, moving on, option number B, 29. Indian Bank today announced the successfully go live of the consolidated CBS platform. This follows the merger of Allahabad Bank and Indian Bank. Okay, so you have to tell the mobile banking app of Indian Bank. Now Allahabad, customer of Allahabad Bank will also use the very banking app of Indian Bank, and the name of this app is Ind Oasis. Okay, RBI sets up a panel to suggest measures for promoting digital lending. Name the committee head, Jayant Kumar Das. He will head this committee of digital lending. Now, question 31, NPA. Banks wrote off loans worth over rupees dash crore in quarter 3. So, it was 25,500. This amount of loan was wrote off in quarter 3. 32. RBI forms expert panel to explore the consolidation of Urban Cooperative Bank. The committee will be headed by former deputy governor of RBI. What is the name of that former governor? This is Indus Viswanathan. Now, in this question, it has been said that RBI said that it would carry out simultaneous purchase and sale of GSEC. The full form of GSEC is government securities worth rupees 10,000 crore on February 25. These operations often referred to as Operation Twist, option B, following the central bank's OMO. What is OMO? Open market operation. So this, the name of this operation was Operation Twist. Okay. Finance Minister Nirmala Sitharaman in the budget announced the prioritization of dash public sector banks and dash general insurance bank insurance company in the 2021 beginning April. So option A is correct. She told that the prioritization of two public sector bank and one GIC means general insurance company will take place in the upcoming months. Then SBI chief Rajneesh Kumar to be an exclusive advisor for dash group. The answer is Kotak Group. Why? For $1 billion stressed asset loan. Okay. Moving on. Who disperses the RIDF? Rural Infrastructure Development Bank. As per budget, Nirmala Sitharaman announced to enhance the allocation to the RIDF to 40,000 crore from 30,000 crore. So, NABARD disperses the RIDF. And full form of RIDF is also important. So, Rural Infrastructure Development Fund. Which of the following ensures that bank have an additional layer of usable capital that can be drawn down when losses are occurred? So the answer is CCB, option C. Okay, basically RBI extended the deadline for meeting the last tranche of capital conservation buffer. Full form is capital conservation buffer by another 6 months. Okay, till October this year due to COVID-19 pandemic. Moving on, question number 38. Check truncation system. So RBI said that CTS, which is currently operational at the major clearing houses of this country, will be made operational across all branches for the country by September 2021. Very easy question. Question number 39. Banks wrote off rupees 62,000 crore loans of top dash willful defaulters as of March 20. RBI tells RBI activist write information. So the answer is 100. So banks wrote off rupees 60,000 crore loans of top 100 willful defaulters as of March 20. Moving on. As many Niti Aayog CEO name. So Niti Aayog CEO name is Amitabh Kant. And as many as 2.3 billion transactions worth 4.2 trillion were recorded through UPI Unified Payment Interface in the month of January this year. Very important. RBI imposes 55 lakh penalty on Pune based Seva Vikas Cooperative Bank for non-adherence to IRAC. What is R in the full form of IRAC? The full form of IRAC is Income Recognition and Asset Classification. The answer is Recognition. Budget government proposes dash 1,000 crore for recapitalization of PSBs, 20,000 crore. The center has allocated 73,000 crore to the Rural Employment Guarantee Scheme for the next fiscal year. What is the name of this scheme? MANREGA. Very easy answer. So 73,000 crore has been allocated for the MANREGA by Finance Minister Nirmala Ji. Now we move to the next question. Rama Mohan Rao is the MD and CEO of SBI Card. Option A is correct. Moving to the question number 45, where is the headquarter of Dhanlakshmi Bank? So J.K. Sivan has become MD and CEO of Dhanlakshmi Bank. The headquarter of Dhanlakshmi Bank is in Thrissur. Thrissur is in Kerala. Kerala, okay. Moving on to question number 46. Which country has been chosen as a country in focus for 51st IEEFI? Bangladesh was the answer. Now question number 47. Which state will become India's prime producer of vanadium? Arunachal Pradesh is the correct answer. Okay, and vanadium is a high value metal used in strengthening steel. Question number 49. Which country has organized 4th One Planet Summit to protect world's biodiversity? So the France is the correct answer. France One Planet Summit. The Narendra Modi has launched and addressed a Startup India International Summit. What is the name of summit? The name of summit was, I think, Prarambh. So Prarambh is the correct answer. Option D is the right answer. Moving to the question number 50. First advanced estimate of NSO as per estimate India's GDP expected to contract by what percent of the current fiscal year 2021? So the answer is 7.7%, but I just told you that second estimate has come out, and as per that, in the earlier videos I told you that mostly quarter three data has come out, and according to that data India's GDP grows by 0.4% in quarter three, okay, and it is estimated that in FY21 GDP will contract by 8%. Okay, so this is the revised estimate, okay, from October to December 2020, means quarter three, means October to December 2020, and this is the second advanced and quarterly estimate of GDP released by the MoSPI. Niti Aayog has collaborated with which e-commerce company to launch a revamp WEF, means Women Entrepreneurship Platform? Flipkart is the correct answer. So Niti has collaborated with Flipkart, and the CEO of Flipkart is Kalyan Krishnamurthy. Founder was Sachin Bansal and Vinny Bansal. Okay, moving to the next question. The Punjab National Bank and IIT, which IIT has collaborated to set up a FinTech Innovation Center? Very, very important question. IIT Kanpur is the correct answer. RBI has cancelled the license of Vasant Dada Nagakari Sahakari Bank. The bank is located in at which place? So this bank is from Maharashtra. Option B. Question 54. World Hindi Day, Hindi Divas, is observed annually on which date? World Hindi Day. So this is observed on January 10. Okay. Moving to question number 55. FWSAI has capped the trans fatty acids amount in food to 3% for 2021 and 10% by 2022. From the current permissible limit of 5%. So the correct answer is 2% by 2022 and 3% by 2021. One. Which state has become the first state in the country to provide 100% LPG gas connection to all households in the state? Question number 56. The correct answer is none. Himachal Pradesh is the correct answer. Okay. To provide 100% LPG gas connection to all households. Who has been appointed as the Deputy Election Commissioner? Umesh Sinha. Option B. Option A, Messina. Name the mobile app for COVID vaccine delivery. So the name of the mobile app is Covin. Okay. Which tech company has signed rupees 24 crore investment deal with Tamil Nadu government to set up its first electric scooter factory in the state? So this is Ola. Okay, this was question number 59. Moving to the question number 60. Just 20 questions is remaining now. The RBI has launched DPI, means Digital Payment Index, to capture the extent of digitization. How many broad parameters are there in DPI? So it consists of 5 broad parameters. Option D. The Government of India has decided to construct the largest floating solar energy project in the world. The project will be constructed at Omkareshwar Dam, which is located on the river. So Omkareshwar Dam is located on the river. I think the correct answer is Narmada. Narmada is the correct answer. Which country recently became the largest Latin American country to legalize abortion? Argentina. Diego Maradona was from Argentina, who just passed away. Modi has dedicated 450 km Kochi-Mangaluru National Gas Pipeline. It is built by which country company? So GAIL is the correct answer. Gas Authority of India Limited. Now, question number 64. RBI recently released 22nd FSR, means Financial Stability Report. As per the report, the Gross National Performing Index ratio of the Scheduled Commercial Bank is to increase to dash by September 21. So the correct answer is 13.5%. Option D, very important. The Ministry of Petroleum and Natural Gas recently launched a campaign to spread awareness about clean energy. Name the campaign. So the name of campaign is option B, Saksham. Question number 66. Name the president of ACC, Jayasa. Who has become the America's first woman Treasury Secretary, Janet Yellen. Option B, D, Janakiram has taken over the new director of IDRBT. This IDRBT is an arm of which institution? So this is an arm of RBI. Option C. Okay. Now the government has approved the ₹5 crore Startup India fund scheme for early stage startup. So this is 945 crore. ICC announces Player of the Month award. First winner is Rishabh Pant. National Tourism Day. So National Tourism Day was held on Jan 25. Okay, Jan 25 is the correct answer. Option B. Government of India and DAS signed a $500 million for strengthening teacher learning and results for states program STARS to improve the quality and governance of school education in 6 Indian states. So this has been done with collaboration with World Bank. Option C. India has ranked 86th in the coronavirus index. Brazil at the top. Which country topped? So New Zealand topped this index. Okay. Now question 74. G7 group of 7 countries. Which of the following is not a member of G7? So India is not a member of G7. Option C. Which country is hosting a multinational national level exercise Aman 2021? Pakistan is the correct answer. Option B. Name the new leader of opposition in Rajya Sabha. Mallikarjun Kharge. Earlier Gulam Nabi Azad was the opposition leader of opposition. Also Rajya Sabha TV and Lok Sabha TV has been merged and named as Sansad TV. Okay. Mathiketan Sola National Park. So this national park is in Kerala. Option C. Konkani language is the official language of Goa. The government proposed changes in the DICGC Act to ensure depositors of troubled banks can withdraw up to 5 lakh. Earlier it was 1 lakh, but now it is 5 lakh. So option D. Ujwala scheme will be expanded to cover over 1 crore more beneficiaries. Okay, so that's it. These were the 200 questions in this particular video. Must subscribe our courses for RBI. And all the best for the upcoming examinations. See you in another video. Till then, bye-bye.